The Mediterranean, the largest enclosed sea on Earth, connecting three continents and surrounded by 22 countries. Cradle of ancient civilizations, source of wealth, recreation, and inspiration, a crossroad of trade. It is claimed that 80% of the overall pollution in the Mediterranean basin is caused by municipal waste, urban wastewater, and industrial pollution. An ambitious initiative has undertaken to tackle these environmental challenges by the year 2020.
I remember some years ago when I was in headquarters in Brussels, the former commissioner, Benita Ferrer-Waldner, started talking about the pollution of the Mediterranean Sea. And that seemed to be a dream. It's perhaps still a dream, but it's an important dream. And now with Horizon 2020, this dream perhaps comes true.
The Mediterranean Sea is a promise for a better future. It provides opportunities for trade, employment, mobility, and cooperation. This is why the Secretariat of the Union for the Mediterranean, in partnership with the European Commission and other partners, aims to address the challenges of the environmental quality of this shared resource and place it at the heart of our projects and initiatives under the Horizon 2020 initiative.
The Horizon 2020 initiative progresses by means of its interrelated components, investments for pollution reduction, capacity building for achieving objectives, review, monitoring, and research. The countries that participate in the initiative face significant environmental challenges and are committed to overcome them through a joint collective effort.
We have already recognized what are the priorities, what are hotspot pollutions that we have to resolve and where we have to intervene. So our expectations are aimed in providing proper framework in a supporting country in fulfilling these challenges.
Il a eu pour le Maroc un impact très positif sur les trois composantes, puisque sur la composante renforcement des capacités, nous avons bénéficié de quelques 8 ateliers nationaux. Et nous avons participé à peu près 25 ateliers régionaux pour quelques 350 bénéficiaires.
In Libya, we unfortunately don't have a good and scientific identification of the hot spots, but I assure you, we do have many. Many of them, they have a relationship to the sewage and wastewater dumping in the Mediterranean. And that includes all the major cities.
البحر المتوسط بحر مسكر يعني مش بس لبنان لحاله في كذا دول لازم يعتمدوا على بعض يشكلوا حلقه واحده ليتعاونوا ليقدروا يحاربوا التلوث.
Saida, Lebanon's third largest city, once a famous port of the Phoenicians, is well known for its ancient civilization, its monuments, and its merchants, who shipped their products to the ends of the earth. Yet in more recent years, Saida is also known for the open dump site on the outskirts of the city, to which the inhabitants refer as the mountain.
Where we're standing now, we can see the mountain, the trash mountain of Saida. And this is being here since 1982. It was around 58 meters high mountain, and it occupied around 60,000 meters squared of area and containing 1.5 million cubic meters of waste.
Especially in the summer, fires erupt from the mountain, and the whole neighborhood is affected by these fires. Actually, even the ashes of the fire, they enter our house sometimes. All the time we hear about people who are going to the hospital for some respiratory issues, and also on more than one occasion, some skin problems happened to some of the people here in the neighborhood.
Most people here, they rely on the sea and they are fishermen. And the fishermen were complaining because nobody wants to come and eat fish from a place next to a dump site.
The marine life is changing drastically day after day, and we have seen that the flora and fauna disappeared in many cases.
This urgent environmental situation demanded an immediate solution. This is why in 2012, the Lebanese Ministry of Environment and the municipality of Saida, in collaboration with the United Nations Development Programme, undertook the rehabilitation of the Saida dump site.
We have started since 2005 to search for a solution for the dump of Saida. But unfortunately, we didn't get to solve it because you have a fresh waste that is coming every day to the dump, so you cannot set some kind of permanent solution for it. It's very difficult to find locations for landfillings. And this is why we're trying in the last 5-6 years to move into waste-to-energy technologies. We'll save a lot of space to dump inert material.
As a response, the capacity building component of Horizon 2020 sent in 2012 a delegation of 12 high-level officials on a 3-day study visit to the Netherlands on waste-to-energy technology. Upon their return, they informed their constituencies and a more balanced exchange of views and approaches was possible.
Horizon 2020 has facilitated a very successful public dialogue in Lebanon on solid waste management, which ended with a big meeting with all stakeholders, local and national authorities, NGOs, industry, who agreed on the Beirut Accord. This includes key points and steps for the continuation, and also the hot issue of solid waste to energy option.
Now, at this stage, within the deadline of the project, we will have a landfill, a closed landfill with the final cap, with gas and leachate collection. In addition to that, we will have public park, around 35,000 meter squares of a green area.
We are now less than 1 year, about 8 months, from the beginning of the project. And I think by the end of 2015, we will have a new site here.
For the first time, we can actually spot the sea from our house. It's facing the sea, just a couple of meters away. Big parts of the mountain is removed. Also, not much fire is erupting in the neighborhood. Yeah, it's changed a lot since then.
The West Bank is 60% of the Palestinian territories. Here, the management of environmental resources and the fight against pollution are extremely difficult.
At the national level, we were engaged in the Horizon 2020 from the early beginning. We attended the ministerial meeting that was held in Cairo in 2006. Which was the start of launching the Horizon 2020. Since that time, we participate in most of its activities on the national, on the regional, and even in the international level, workshops and training programs.
For Palestine, the Shared Environmental Information System has allowed a significant evolution in the management of environmental data.
The EMP SAIS project is an important project which is being funded by the European Commission in order to support the implementation of the Shared environment information system in the European neighbourhood. It's been set up in order to align the work in the neighbourhood countries with that of the EU countries in terms of collecting information and data, making assessments on the state of the environment. It's being put together in particular for the support of the Horizon 2020 project, as well as in collaboration with the UNEP MAP and the countries.
We take the metadata of the six indicators that are proposed by the SAIS and implement them or merge them within our Palestinian environmental information system and add our own indicators on the same frame, on the same metadata.
Now we are in the facility of Almenia landfill, which will serve the southern West Bank, including all municipalities in the two governorates, Hebron and Bethlehem, with around 700 to 800,000 inhabitants that will be using the landfill.
This landfill has been designed to accommodate 600 to 700 tons of waste per day. Its facilities have been constructed according to strictest standards.
As you can see, the leachate, which is the most hazardous part of the municipal waste, is collected in the leachate pond and, of course, treated by natural evaporation. Go on. The other problem that also you will see is the social effect. Our target is, of course, to eliminate any waste picking informal, and of course making modern facilities for waste picking to encourage and incentive the waste recycling.
Horizon 2020 has complemented the efforts of many donors. The sanitary landfill was funded by the World Bank, the Axis Road by USAID, the transport and recycling equipment by the EU, and the transfer stations and other facilities by the Palestinian Municipal Support Program.
The institutional framework, the technical, the financial and the public awareness is really, really, really supported by the program of Horizon 2020. And of course, I think it will continue till we reach the target that we can say proudly that we have the capacity on different levels adopting the idea of clean Mediterranean after 2020.
To strengthen awareness, Palestine has introduced major reforms in the educational system so that environmental protection is well addressed. NGOs complement these efforts.
هذا شيء مهم كثير بالنسبة لنا احنا كطلاب وفي المدرسة كثير بيشجعونا انه نحافظ على البيئة ونحافظ على النظافة واحنا اكيد كطلاب شيء مهم يعني دورنا كبير جدا خصوصا احنا طلاب كبار نقدر نعطي ننقلها للاصغر منا احنا الشباب احنا القادرين نغير هذا الشيء.
Despite differences in specificities, the countries of the region share common environmental management challenges.
Israel is facing major environmental challenges. It's a very densely populated country with a high growth rate. It has a lot of the problems of a developing country, along with the consumption levels and production levels of an industrialized country. These problems are across borders, so it's very important to collaborate with neighboring countries on these issues. And on these aspects, Horizon 2020 helped the Ministry of Environmental Protection and Israel as a whole to build the capacities needed to deal with these problems.
Fifteen years ago, this park on the outskirts of Tel Aviv had been a huge open waste dumping site. For years, it was known as the Mountain of Waste. Until 1998, it received daily about 3,000 tons of waste, and it was more than 60 meters high.
This dump was operating for about 50 years, and in 1999 we closed the dump. From that time, we had to take any measures to keep the dangers of this thing of we call the dump.
One of the dangers was the explosions and fires connected to methane gas. A system was constructed in order to remove it. 84 extraction wells collect the gas and conduct it 4 kilometers away to a textile plant.
We are preventing the gas from going to the atmosphere in one hand, preventing the pollution from the textile factory because it was using mazut. So instead of using mazut, it's used now the methane gas, which is natural gas.
A new facility under construction will assure the separation of 1,500 tons of solid municipal waste per day. Materials of high caloric value will be packed and sent to a cement plant.
Actually, it's RDF, and the one who is operating this facility is the cement plant, because it should be in charge of the materials in the end of the day. We had to make sure that the cement plant is our contractor, and they are in charge to make this product and to take care of it.
The upgrade of the area was launched in 2004. A park known as the Ariel Sharon Park was designed around the mountain.
I think the cooperation between municipalities and learning from each other is very important. And Horizon 2020 is one part of this that can be challenging all the participants to learn from each other and to be more effective in the end of the day.
I think the Horizon 2020 training gave me more in-depth insight about education for sustainable development and how important it is. For example, this research work program that we have is giving the students more tools, not just knowledge, but how to change their behavior. They also disseminate this information to the people around them, their family, the teacher, the community.
Members of parliaments are also key actors that need to be involved in the common effort for a cleaner Mediterranean. At a regional level, the capacity-building component of Horizon 2020 has involved the region's legislators in its work program and built the bridge with the Parliamentary Assembly of the Union for the Mediterranean.
We can all fight. Therefore, it's important that Horizon invited also parliamentarians, that we can show each other which kind of laws can help to reach the goals.
Here having the parliamentarians and having the journalists and having the civil society, I think they are all the three components that you can make the change at the national, the regional level, because you can establish the legislations and you can also raise the public awareness and you can advocate for it. So you have all the elements inside this room.
Egypt, solid waste is a very serious problem.
For years, we have not managed our waste issues properly. We're looking for local solutions based on labor-intensive actions that will lead eventually to zero waste, so that everything is recovered, recycled. We're looking for regional solutions as well, because we realize that whatever we toss out here will end up on the shores of another country. That's why Horizon 2020 is of supreme importance to us as a regional initiative.
Horizon 2020 has helped Egypt introduce new waste management technologies, including waste to energy, which was presented to a competent group of Egyptian professionals during a study visit organized by the capacity building component in Belgium and the Netherlands.
We
had a great opportunity to see and discuss and listen to the European experience in waste to energy. Waste to energy is one component of the waste solid waste management cycles.
Kafr el-Sheikh is one of Egypt's poorest governorates. Its cities and villages are spread around a big lake known as Lake Borulus. Natural canals connect the lake on the one side with the Mediterranean and on the other with the Nile. Once the lake was clean, a small paradise for its inhabitants.
بحيرة البرولوس كنا احنا متعودين ان احنا نشرب ميه ونطبخ منها يعني انا انزل البحيره ممكن ما اخدش ميه معايا
الاول كانت بتدي عطاء جامد كانت الاول الصياد بينزل يعني كان صياد
النهارده بقى عندي الصرف الزراعي اللي بينزل بحيره البرولس ما بقى صرف زراعي ده بقى صرف زراعي وصناعي وصرف صحي وصرف استزراعي المزارع اللي هي بتحط مخلفات في الاراضي الزراعيه
Pollution from sewage and sewage sludge makes things much worse.
القريه اللي انا فيها ما فيهاش صرف صحي بتعتمد على ترانشات بتيجي عربيات تشيلها بترميها فين الله اعلم
It happened that most of this wastewater is being dumped to the lake. So that's why we were lucky that you know Horizon 2020 was talking about the Mediterranean and how to improve the lakes and the Mediterranean for from pollution.
Horizon 2020 responded to the Egyptian government's efforts and their request to expand its operations to the northern part of Kafr el-Sheikh. The program has helped to complete the feasibility study for Kafr el-Sheikh and to support Egypt in submitting investment and loan proposals. The project aims to reduce the pollution of Lake Borulus, reverse the negative impacts on the health of the inhabitants and on fishery, and gradually restore the lake to its initial state.
57 villages. We're talking about 500,000 Egyptians will benefit from this project. So I think in the end, this also will contribute to improve the environment around Kafr el-Sheikh.
عمري 26 سنة، أنا خلقت هون، أنا بيتي هون، خلقت وربيت على البحر، عنا إياها من جد جدودنا يعني. في أنواع من الزبالة اللي بتنزل بالبحر، مش عبلة المجارير، المجارير مضرة بتلوث المي بس في الدواليب وكاس النايلون، هول ما بيتحللوا لا بالمي وحلا حتى على البر بيتحللوا. هي بنعاني منه مثلا السمكة بتاكلهم بتختنق، حتى الزلاحف لها منافع كثير بالبحر. كمان عم تاكلهم وبتختنق
Indeed, on the small piece of sandy beach in the Rambla al-Baida, sea turtles still make their nests. Since the Al Gadir wastewater treatment plant started operating and until today, the population of South Beirut has considerably grown, and the plant only offers preliminary treatment. Now there is will, knowledge, and commitment to deal with these challenges. The expansion of the sewage network and the extension and upgrade of the Al Gadir wastewater treatment plant is a priority project of Horizon 2020. The feasibility study has already been completed, and the project is now on its way to investment and implementation.
The only missing now is to ensure the money. When we have the money, I think from now, we will have about 3 years to complete this work, and we will participate for sure in elimination big quantity of pollution from the sea.
We are doing all
all countries to face these major problems. And this is why we need to rely on non-conventional water. This is why undoubtedly I can recommend the continuation of such a program as Horizon 2020.
I have gained a lot of experience in that training courses. It's very beneficial when you come back to your country to look at things maybe differently than the way you used to look at them.
First, life cycle thinking.
Distance learning modules dedicated to the focal areas of the Horizon 2020 initiative have also been developed. User-friendly, interactive, and self-paced, they have been designed specifically for the busy practitioner, administrator, professional, student, and NGO staff member working for a cleaner Mediterranean. Environmental challenges in Jordan concentrate in Al Qaeda that is located 85 kilometers north of Amman. The site started receiving industrial and solid waste from the Irbid governorate in 1981. Today it serves four governorates and more than 30 communities with a total population of more than 1 million inhabitants. The narrow valley of El Kaiter is located on the borders with Syria.
Hopefully that in the very near future we will be able to do something managing the site in a very proper way to eliminate the environmental impacts which comes from this problem.
In the last 3 years, many hundreds of thousands of refugees from Syria have also arrived. Many of them work under a local contractor. They collect plastic, which is sent for recycling.
I hope that also the European Union also will aid Jordan and the host communities in order to build their infrastructure to give good services to the Syrian refugees here in Jordan.
El Kaiter has been identified by the Jordanian government as a hotspot and has become one of the priority projects of Horizon 2020. The expected positive impact of the project includes upgrade of the site's overall environmental performance, protection of the water table of the Yarmouk River basin, and avoid potential danger of cross-border pollution towards Syria. In its efforts to deal with the demanding common environmental challenges, Jordan is one of the first countries in the MENA region to adopt green economy as a national target.
There's still pollution going into the Mediterranean. People are still suffering from the lack of water supply, clean, quality water supply. So this is where the new concept of a green economy is I think the most important.
The government of Jordan has asserted the need to launch a program to meet the requirements for adhering to environmental standards and turning Jordan into a regional center for green services and industries. Horizon 2020 supports Jordan's transition towards a green economy.
We started out in 2008 with the Eco Cities Forum. We've done cleaner production separately with UNEP. The EcoCities was an initiative by the ministry, and we have other similar green initiatives.
The government take a decision that to establish a unit specialized on the head of the Minister of Environment that to plan for the green economy in Jordan.
So we finished the scoping study, but we haven't developed it yet into a full-fledged green economy strategy. So we look forward and we look very, very anxiously to the Horizon 2020 and to others to support Jordan in preparing the second phase.
There is a cooperation between our ministry and the Ministry of Higher Education and the universities. There is a new generation. They're very aware about the importance of the environment.
For a harmonized regional approach to education, the Mediterranean Strategy on Education for Sustainable Development was finalized under Horizon 2020 and endorsed by the Union for the Mediterranean Ministers of Environment and Climate Change that took place in Athens in May 2014.
Are the most important sources for the Palestinian economy. This sector contributes 5% to the country's GDP and employs more than 30,000 employees. However, there are also negative impacts on the environment. Near Beit Fajar village in Bethlehem lies an area full of stone quarries. It is the source of unprocessed stone for the entire industry of Palestine.
الوضع اللي احنا انتو مطلعين بعينيتو شايفين الوضع اللي بتتفرجوا عليه واحنا دورنا كراب لا يعني بنعرف لا بننام في الليل ولا بنعرف نتحرك والطينة مش طبيعية يعني لو في وضع انه يتحسن يعني لو في شكل كاتم صوات او كبسات طينة او شغلات اللي تخفف البيئة والطبيعة اللي احنا عندنا فيها.
Around 10% of the plants have installed water recycling systems. Things, however, seem to gradually be improving. The Palestinian Authority plans to reform the stone quarries in the area for the benefit of all.
تنظر البلدة إلى تطوير هذه المنطقة بحيث تصبح منطقة صناعية مصانع الحجر اللي في البلدة متفرقة بحيث تكون مصانع الحجر في هذه المنطقة وتصبح منطقة صناعية لكل البلدة.
In Palestine, we have more than 1,500 entities in different scales, from crushers, quarries, cutting factories, and small workshops. Horizon 2020 could be a very important and essential initiative that can contribute in this regard.
The program has already supported Palestine in this sector. The capacity building component has trained members of the Union of Stone and Marble, which is the official representative of all employees in this industry.
I have participated in many workshops and training sessions organized by Horizon 2020. And here we highlight the importance of the participation of the staff from the factories, not just from the institution itself.
There are many other industries that contribute to the pollution of the Mediterranean. At a regional level, Horizon 2020 focused on the iron and steel industry, which is by its nature a heavy and polluting one. Within the capacity building component, the University of Athens mapped the 107 plants that are situated within a distance of 50 kilometers from the coastline and calculated their pollution load.
By examining sediment cores, we are in a position to demonstrate that the implementation of pollution reduction technologies in combination with EU and national regulation and legislation have resulted to impressive improvements of the state of the environment over the last 35 years. Now with Horizon 2020, we try to extrapolate that and calculate the reduction of pollution load if best available techniques and appropriate legislation are implemented throughout the Mediterranean.
The basic guidelines for an appropriate strategy for the iron and steel mill industry will be discussed with the sector and competent authorities at a regional workshop co-organized with UNEP-MAP. Percent of the world's olive oil is produced in the Mediterranean, mostly by small olive mills. But along with the olive oil, 30 million cubic meters of wastewater are also produced every year.
In Israel, the problem is very, very severe because now what people do, olive millers, and not all of them, of course, dispose olive mill wastewater through the sewage system. This gets into the wastewater treatment plants and cause collapse of the treatment process of the sanitary wastewater.
Olive mill wastewater is phytotoxic and hard to dissolve. One of the main problems it causes when dumped into the sea, into lakes or rivers, is that it consumes oxygen, takes a long time to decompose, and reduces biodiversity. Erez Avramov processes olive oil with a method which does not require the addition of water, thus reducing the quantity of waste and making it more solid. In this way, instead of throwing it away, he spreads it as a kind of fertilizer for his olive trees.
כמות הגפת שאנחנו מפזרים לדונם זה בדרך כלל סביב ה-2-3 קוב לדונם גפת, שזה למעשה, זה כולל, זה 40% מוצקים ו-60% מי עקר. יתרון נוסף שיש לדבר הזה, זה שאנחנו רואים שבקיץ שאנחנו באים ואנחנו מרימים ככה את הגפת, אנחנו רואים שהאדמה נשארת לחה מתחת לגפת. זאת אומרת שזה מחזיק לנו מים ומונע עיבוד של מים בהתעדות. כזה דבר גורם לנו, מאפשר לנו להשקות בפחות מים.
Horizon 2020 undertook the initiative to help Mediterranean countries to find solutions for olive mill wastewater treatment. Thus, it organized capacity-building activities at regional, sub-regional, and national levels, in which Israel had the opportunity to participate and meet colleagues from neighboring countries.
We don't talk about a regular industry. It's a traditional industry with very, very unique characteristics. We can think about low-tech solutions like we saw here today. The idea is to cooperate, to share information, to make regional schemes. And this is why the Horizon 2020 initiative is so important for us, to help us gain this advantage.
Protection contre la pollution du lac de Bizerte en Tunisie est le premier projet préparé par l'initiative Horizon 2020 et qui a été labellisé par l'Union pour la Méditerranée. Par ce label, les 43 pays membres reconnaissent que ce projet contribue aux objectifs de l'Union.
Apart from the European Investment Bank, the European Bank for Reconstruction and Development is also supportive of the Lake Bizerte project. The total budget is over 90 million euros in a five-year period, starting in 2014.
Donc le projet Lac de Bizerte, sa préparation était une préparation vraiment exemplaire dans le sens de l'approche participative dans la conception du projet et les engagements aussi à faire réussir l'exécution du projet et assurer la pérennisation par la suite.
The story of Lake Bizerte is lost in the mists of time. The most ancient city in Tunisia was connected for the first time with the Mediterranean in the 12th century BC, in the age of the Phoenicians. Today, the big lagoon of Bizerte connects to the Mediterranean through a 10-kilometer long canal. Gradually, big tourist establishments were built along the coastal road. Fishing and shellfish farming increased while big industries sprung up on the banks. The lake's water quality has deteriorated, and the well-being of both ecosystems and inhabitants is under pressure.
الأنواع التلوث اللي موجودة يعني في المنطقة هذه ثم التلوث الهوائي الانبعاثات الغازية ثم التلوث المائي المياه الملوثة اللي يقع التخلص منها مباشرة في مياه البحيرة
One of the economic sectors that suffers more from the pollution of the lake is shellfish farming.
La lagune de Bizerte est habilitée à actuellement la production conchylicole avoisine les 1000 tonnes par an. C'est une petite production par rapport aux potentialités de la lagune. Ce type de production est très sensible à la qualité des eaux.
Horizon 2020 has undertaken here three basic investment actions and a set of capacity building and other interventions. Three industrial plants will be retrofitted, the solid waste management system will be improved, and the sewage system upgraded.
Il y a eu une complémentarité et une coordination entre les deux composantes infrastructure, investissement et la composante renforcement de capacité. C'est le cas du projet de Bizerte où un atelier a permis donc d'engager les parties prenantes autour d'une charte qui a été élaborée d'une manière concertée, ce qui a un impact positif dans le futur, dans la mesure où il permettrait un plus grand engagement pour la mise en œuvre ultérieure de ce projet fort important pour la Tunisie.
One of the most important sources of pollution is located on the south of the lake, in the area of Menzel Bourguiba. The area is a big industrial zone with factories and dockyards dependent mainly on metallurgy.
اللي ننتظروه من المشروع يعني في المستقبل ننتظروه أن يكون عنده وجود إيجابي يعني نحبه يكون ثم حاجة ملموسة مباشرة اللي يحسها المواطن البسيط.
All stakeholders are involved in the implementation of the Lake Bizerte Charter. The competent ministries, the industrialists, farmers, fishermen and civil society as well.
احنا كمجتمع المدني مش معناه مش كجمعيتنا برك والجمعيات الاخرين المخاطين في المشروع كذلك قمنا بالامضاء وكان الامضاء في وزارة البيئة وكان معناها في وصار احتفال كبير يعني في عملية معنى امضاء الشارت هذا للمشروع. الهدف من المشروع مش فقط تطهير البحيرة ولكن كيف نحافظ على بحيرة نظيفة مدى الحياة.
The first phase of the Horizon 2020 program is now completed with activities in 12 countries, 4 investment projects in implementation, and more than 70 projects under preparation. Progress made was reviewed at this midpoint in the initiative, and the Union for the Mediterranean Ministers in Charge of Environment and Climate Change unanimously acknowledged in their Athens Declaration in May 2014 that the initiative should continue without losing the momentum gained.
Quite obvious that Horizon 2020 is a very valuable initiative. It's connecting all the nations which are sharing the Mediterranean region and also some other countries which are interested in the development of Mediterranean in a responsible way.
Donc vous voyez que nous sommes à mi-parcours de cette initiative. Les retombées sont à tout point de vue positives et nous avons examiné aujourd'hui donc lors de cette conférence ministérielle, la prochaine phase.
The Youth Fund will surely have a key role in the identification of meaningful and concrete action to somehow contain and counteract future sources of pollution, of course in collaboration with partner countries and organizations.
Infrastructures have been put in place which are already in a number of areas perceptibly showing that improvements are being made. We are aware that there is much still to do.
The
capacity building component, apart from enhancing the human capital of the region with more than 150 workshops and other activities and 3,500 trainees, has made Horizon 2020 an effective platform for synergies and cooperation with regional programs, something on which we need to capitalize.
We are happy that we have completed the feasibility studies and the loan negotiations are taking place on the four feasibility studies that we undertook during MESIP 1. And there are 2.6 billion worth of projects waiting to be financed in the three sectors of MESIP.
The great benefits to the countries are that if we're successful in this project, then the information they make available once will be available for many different purposes.
Hopefully that we will see more of this fruitful cooperation, and hopefully that we will be also seeing more projects implemented in the ground in order to show our people that we are really doing something for their own benefits.
Libya has the longest coastline on the Mediterranean, and we expect that our partners and friends, the countries of the Mediterranean, pay more attention to Libya and assist Libya in the situation that we are going through now.
We look forward from the new phase for Horizon 2020 to highlight the climate change adaptation techniques, tools, and methodologies in order to benefit our people.
Pour le futur, je proposerai peut-être de renforcer le programme, surtout au niveau thématique.
We're midway now, as we are now in 2014. Our mission and vision is to move with Horizon 2020 towards the year 2020, but I truly believe that it's even beyond.
All of the participants have confirmed that they consider the Horizon 2020 process has been a very positive one, is genuinely adding value to the cooperation in the region between the different countries and bringing them together to focus on this very important target of how we can collectively address the problems of the Mediterranean.